Peter Sweden here. Is a civil war imminent in Sweden? I'm not saying it is, but there is some interesting things that's been happening in Sweden the last few days that I thought I wanted to update you guys about. All the leaders for the three biggest political parties in Sweden have recently talked about war. Now, Jimmy Åkesson, the leader for the nationalist Swedish Democrat Party in Sweden, which is the third biggest party in Sweden right now, said that, quote, a war is being waged on Swedish society. Also on the same day, Ulf Kristersson, the leader for the Moderates Party in Sweden, which is currently the second biggest party in Sweden, said that people are running around shooting people and running around with hand grenades as if there was a war in Sweden. And then we also have the Prime Minister of Sweden for the biggest party, the Socialist Party, which are in government currently. He was actually talking about considering deploying the military into no-go zones, into these suburbs, to get rid of the criminal gang violence in Sweden. And they all said this on the same day. And I actually talked about this in Parliament as well. Now this only comes a couple of days after the Swedish government sends out the leaflets to 4.7 million households in Sweden, warning them what to do in case of a terrorist attack or what to do in case of war. Now the Swedish government hasn't done this since World War II. So last time they did this was back in World War II when they sent out leaflets to households warning them what to do in case of war, you know, what they need to pack, the essentials, what to do, and so on and so on. And now the Swedish government has sent that out again to all of the households in Sweden, warning people. I mean, this is really strange. The Swedish government is sending out leaflets warning Swedes to prepare for war. And then a couple of days later, they're talking about deploying the military into no-go zones, and they're talking about the war. All the three biggest parties talking about it in Sweden. Now, you know, just a few days ago here, the police station in the Swedish city of Malmö was bombed, presumably by a hand grenade. Two police cars were completely destroyed in the explosion. And this only comes a couple of weeks after a pensioner was killed by a hand grenade attack in Stockholm. Now, if you have been following my reporting, it's been a really insane amount of bombings and so on in Sweden. There's been 200 explosions last year, which is insane. Considering there's only 10 million people living in Sweden, you know, if you would compare that per capita with a country like America, which has 320 million people, the equivalent, if what happened in Sweden would have happened in America, the equivalent would be 6,500 explosions, bombings, which is an insane amount number. I mean, you know, even the Swedish police has said that all the hand grenade attacks in Sweden is unprecedented for a country that is not at war. So there really is a hand grenade slash bombing crisis in Sweden. And, I mean, what are they going to do to stop this? I mean, they cannot just let these criminal gangs run around with hand grenades. Oh, and did I mention, a RPG, a rocket propelled grenade, was found just outside Stockholm a couple of months ago as well. And also just a few days ago, a grenade launcher, another military weapon, was found inside a factory, a paper factory in fact. A grenade launcher was found inside it. I mean, how many of these weapons catchers are there in Sweden with grenade launchers, RPGs? I mean, they're just missing tanks and fighter jets now to have a complete army. I mean, what is going on here in Sweden? Are these criminal gangs in these no-go zones, are they building up caches of weapons? Are they building up for something? I don't know. But it's really interesting stuff happening in Sweden, and I'm just speculating here. But I'm seeing some worrying signs in Sweden. You know, what are they going to do to stop these grenade attacks and these bombings? You know, 200 explosions in just 1 year, it's a lot. You know, they have to stop this. And the only way to stop this, I mean, some politicians have, they actually proposed a grenade amnesty where people can hand in their grenades freely. Without any, yeah, that's not gonna happen. I mean, the criminals not gonna go along with that. You know, yeah. I mean, are they gonna have an RPG and grenade launcher amnesty as well? A tank amnesty? No, it's not gonna work. The only real solution for them to do, and I mean, they really do should know this themselves, even though it's not politically correct. They should know that the only real solution is to is to do some heavy, some tough-handed action in getting rid of these criminal gangs and their weapons. And basically, what they have to do is deploy the military and clear out these no-go zones by force. I mean, that's the only solution that I can see to this problem in Sweden. And the Swedish Prime Minister has now suggested it. And the thing is, the problem is, if they do this, if they deploy the military into these no-go zones, these criminals are not going to give up freely. They're not just going to give up freely. No, these guys have RPGs, grenade launchers, hand grenades, automatic machine guns, AK-47s. These guys are heavily armed. They're not going to give up willingly. I don't think that's in the equation at all in their minds. So what's going to happen if the, you know, there's already been a few examples, you know, of the Swedish police dealing with these criminal gangs. You know, they've been doing drugs raids and weapons raids and so on. And you know what's happened, you know, in the Swedish city Uppsala when they did this, they kind of tried to get a bit of revenge on the police. They did a drugs raid, and one day later, a hand grenade was thrown at a police car in the Swedish city of Uppsala. Luckily, that grenade missed the police car and exploded just a little bit away from the police car, but it was still an attack on the police. And, you know, police officers had their family members kidnapped in Sweden last year. In the middle of the night, a police chief in the Swedish city of Täby had his car blown up in the middle of the night at his private home, as likely as some kind of revenge from these criminal gangs for the work that they've been doing against them. So they're doing this. Imagine what would happen if they put in the military against these criminal gangs. I mean, a kind of a mini civil war would break out between the criminal gangs and the Swedish army if they did this, because they were not going to give. I mean, they're not going to give up easily or willingly. So is that why they sent out these leaflets warning people what to do in case of war? Is that the real reason? What is the real reason here? Because I kind of get the feeling that there's something going on behind the scenes here with all these leaflets being sent out, with all of the politicians talking about the war. I kind of get the feeling that something is happening behind the scenes here that they're not telling us. So are they preparing to deal with these no-go zones, these criminal gangs by force with the military? Because that would likely cause some kind of civil war in Sweden between the military and them. And it probably wouldn't end very, very nice, because these guys are heavily armed and the Swedish military is heavily armed, so that wouldn't be too nice. So is that what's going on behind the scenes here? I'm just speculating. But there's been some of these strange things going on in Sweden that kind of makes me think. And so I just want to put my thoughts out there, guys. What do you think, guys? Let me know in the comments below, and make sure to give this video a like, subscribe if you haven't done so, and make sure to hit the notification bell to get notifications whenever new videos come out. And thank you so much for watching, guys, and make sure to share this on social media as well, on Facebook, Twitter, everywhere you can, to help get the truth out there about what's happening in Sweden, because many people don't know what's happening in Sweden because the mainstream media is so trying to quiet it down, you know. So make sure to share this. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you later.
Thank you so much for watching, guys. As you know, it's not that cheap to do independent journalism like I am doing, reporting the truth about what's actually happening in Sweden and in the world. Now, as you might know, PayPal recently banned me from their website, so I cannot get supported that way anymore. If you want to support my work, anything would be highly appreciated, so that we can help beat the globalist mainstream media that are not reporting the truth about what's happening because they have a biased agenda. If you want to support me, you can now do so either on Patreon or the new free speech website Maker Support, where you can either do a one-time donation or support me monthly if you so wish. And if you support me with $10 or more per month, you will be featured in the credits in the end of all of my videos. Now, of course, if you want to stay anonymous and not be mentioned in credits, that's also completely fine. But here goes today's shout out to my wonderful supporters on Maker Support and Patreon.